朝鲜发射了至今为止射程最远的弹道导弹，让东亚局势严重升级。美国和韩国今天强势回应了，美韩军演往东海发射了四枚地对地导弹，向朝鲜展示精准打击能力。全球各国谴责平壤当局违反安理会决议，鲁莽行事。而美国更是要求联合国安理会星期三召开紧急会议，讨论朝鲜局势，可是遭到了中俄两国阻拦。
朝鲜昨天推动了今年挑衅意味最浓厚的导弹试射后，正在进行联合军演的美国和韩国今天凌晨各自向东海方向发射了两枚陆军战术系统地对地短程导弹，向平壤当局展示威力。同一天，韩国军方也发射了一枚玄武二型导弹，可是发射不久后就失败坠落，没有人员伤亡。朝鲜导弹五年内第一次掠过日本上空，日本北部地区响起了防空警报，要居民紧急避难，铁路交通还一度停驶。美国总统拜登和日本首相岸田文雄星期二通话后，重申华府对日本防卫铁一般坚定的承诺，美日韩将会紧密合作，与国际社会协调最新回应和长期方案。美国国务院表明，美方愿意无条件对话和开放外交沟通，可是平壤当局并没有同等回应。
We condemn, this dangerous and reckless launch of a long-range ballistic missile that flew over Japan, and it posed an unacceptable threat to the Japanese public. This action is a clear violation of multiple resolutions adopted by the UN Security Council.And it again demonstrates the threat that the DPRK holds, both as it relates to its unlawful weapons of mass destruction program, but also its ballistic missiles program, and the threat that it poses to its neighbors as well. Together with the international community, we call on the DPRK to refrain from further provocations and to engage in sustained and substantive dialogue.
朝鲜这次试射的是一枚可以搭载核弹头打到美国关岛的导弹。各界最担心的就是这个独裁政权下一步会不会进行核试。
I don't want to speculate on whether they will or not. As you know, there has been indications in the past that the DPRK is preparing a test site for what would be its seventh nuclear test. If they do such a test,from our perspective, it would clearly constitute a grave escalatory action and seriously threaten regional and international security and stability. Regardless, we continue to work with our Republic of Korea and Japanese partners for all contingencies, and again, we're calling the DPRK to cease these type of destabilizing and unlawful actions.
联合国秘书长古特雷斯严厉谴责朝鲜的导弹挑衅，形容这鲁莽行为违反了联合国安理会决议，也罔顾国际飞航和海事安全。他再次要求朝鲜恢复对话，让半岛去核化，达到永续和平。实际上，美国要求安理会星期三召开会议讨论朝鲜危机，可是有外交官透露，作为常任理事国的中国和俄罗斯阻止公开讨论这个课题。